portable oil-fired heaters, such as Dayton here. Up on the work table, we have a couple of them that are in different stages of teardown. They have different styles, but pretty much they have similar components. This one you can see a spark plug as the igniter. This one over here is a little more high tech. It's got an electric heater for igniter. They have a fan that creates the fuel part. This generates air to the hose into a venturi, sucks it out of fuel tank and through a fuel nozzle, and is ignited. Out comes heat. The maintenance on these things is fairly simple. So you can remove the air filters, clean them out. As you can see, they can get quite dirty. And then down here in the fuel, there is a fuel rod with a filter in it. And if you can see, this one is actually kind of dirty. I don't know if I can get it in the camera, but there is debris in this filter that can be pulled out, cleaned out, and reinstalled. It just pops in and out. Fairly simple there. The way they work, this one has the electronic igniter. Let me plug this in and show that to you real quick. Need three hands to do this. Turn this on, you can see it ignite. It's starting to generate heat. As soon as the control module senses enough heat, this one, as you would imagine, creates a spark since it has a spark plug. This one's a little bit faster. It doesn't have the control module, but that one does. To service them, like I said, you clean that fuel filter there, this filter there, you clean the spark plug, clean or replace the fuel nozzle as needed. You got a couple of screws here to pull this whole plate out. You have access to the fuel nozzle. This is a photocell that pops out, that both of them have it, the safety circuit. When that photocell inside there senses light from the flame, it allows this unit to stay on. When it does not, they have this one, the lower tech, has a little relay that pops out, shuts the power off to the unit. This one here has the same thing, but it's all electronic. See the electronics in these control board, and this style also has this problem here where the igniter burns itself out. That has to be replaced. To test the fuel photocell, number one, you make sure it's clean. That was the problem with this one. It had big spider webs in it. You can put light to it, disconnect the two leads off of it, and you'll read continuity across those two leads. With light, darkness, there will not be continuity. That's how the photocells work. Clean the photocell, clean the fuel nozzle, clean the electrode or the igniter. Clean these. The fuel pump, it has veins in it. We'll go down in a different video, but that's inside here. But the general maintenance on these units is just basically cleaning filters, cleaning the fuel nozzle, making sure the electrode is working properly, and checking the photocell. And then they will work properly as long as you have the cover installed on there correctly to create the right type of airflow through the unit. And they're just held on with hex screws. Quite simple. That is a basic maintenance on a oil-fired portable heater.